Welcome to the Heavy Spoilers Show. I'm your host, Deffinition, and this episode we're breaking down the Train to Busan sequel, Peninsula. The trailer for the upcoming film has just dropped, and the post-apocalyptic first look has a lot to unpack from it. Throughout this video, we're going to be going over everything you need to know about the movie, including its storyline, cast, and a lot more. There will be heavy spoilers here, so if you haven't seen the first film yet and don't want anything ruined about it, then I highly suggest that you turn off now. Make sure you subscribe to the channel for videos like this every day, and please drop a thumbs up if you enjoy the content. With that out of the way, thank you for clicking this. Now let's get into our breakdown of Peninsula. Okay, so Train to Busan pretty much flew under the radar when it was first released. However, due to word of mouth and it genuinely being a great movie, it's picked up a massive following over the 4 years since it was released. Not only was Train to Busan an incredible zombie story, it was also an incredible human one too that centered around a workaholic and his relationship with his daughter. Set to the backdrop of a zombie outbreak, the first movie allowed us to experience the horror that such an infection would cause. There were lockdowns, huge hordes of the undead, and the train allowed us to watch the disease spread throughout the country as the characters traversed it. All in all, it was a brilliant film, and a lot of fans, including myself, have sat with bated breath waiting for a follow-up to it. That's where Peninsula comes in. Now, most of us just assume that it would be called Train to Busan 2, however, Peninsula as a title could indicate a number of things. Firstly, a peninsula is a piece of land almost surrounded by water or projecting out into a body of water. However, Korea itself is often classified as a peninsula, so the movie will likely be taking place solely in the country. So we can assume from this that, similar to the train outbreak, we will see things from this central location, namely the country. Typically in movies, sequels tend to scale up from the prior film, so with the first movie taking place predominantly on a train, the next step up from this would be an island, city, or who knows, maybe even the entire country itself. The premise of the film was released alongside the trailer, and it states, 4 years after the events of Train to Busan, there is nothing left of Korea except its geography. A crew on a retrieval mission come under attack, and in the process, discover more survivors. So, we can guess that the mercenaries have went in to retrieve something, or pick up supplies in a part of Korea that is thought to be completely wiped out. We do see aspects of this in the new teaser, and judging by the title, I think it's a safe assumption to make. I will discuss more aspects of the trailer later in the video, but that's just the basic meaning behind the title and what it could indicate about the project. Now, though we don't have a confirmed release date in the trailer, and a lot of sites are listing this as unknown, it is currently scheduled to come out on the 12th of August 2020 on IMDb. Whether this remains due to the current lockdown that's in the movie business, the fact that it was scheduled for then means it was likely close to completion before the date was announced. So, as long as the world is back in shipshape condition, we will be getting it for the summer. In 2018, it was confirmed that director James Wan would be a producer on the project, so we know that it has been in development for a while. One is of course well versed in the horror universe, and the director has been behind a lot of big blockbusters in the genre, including the Conjuring films. Gary Dauberman is also penning the project, and you may know the writer from It Chapter 1, and 2, and Annabelle 3. Yeon Sang-ho, whose name I've definitely butchered, is returning to the director's chair, and he has likely overseen all of the writing process and pre-production to make sure that everything is in line with his original vision. So, depending on whether you like It, 1, and the original, probably will make you more or less hyped for the film. It does feel like it's in safe hands for me, and hearing the names attached to it definitely does make me a lot more excited. So, as for the trailer itself, it picks up in real time, 4 years after the outbreak of the zombie apocalypse. As mentioned earlier in the video, Korea is completely in ruins, and it's almost unrecognizable. Though the trailer does state that it is in an abandoned world, I do believe that the outbreak hasn't spread worldwide, and I think the term world is just referring to this landscape being its own thing. I think what will happen is that the film will follow a similar sort of aesthetic to 28 Weeks Later, with the country being in quarantine while the rest of the world keep their distance. They do have night vision goggles and quite high-tech gear, so it definitely seems like they are from a more developed part of the planet. We pick up with the crew making their way on the retrieval mission and seeing firsthand the devastation. If my hypothesis is right and the rest of the world is fine, then it is unlikely that they will need to look for supplies, so I think that the mission will be to retrieve what could have possibly caused the outbreak. You know how zombie movies like to do. I can see them being sent in on a mission that's a need-to-know basis, and then only discovering that it's tied to the undead upon reaching it. The main character will then have the option to follow orders or to destroy it. That's purely me guessing, so yeah, I'm probably wrong, but hey, we do like to theorize here. Anyway, we are now in the shoes of a mysterious character played by Gang Dong Wan. If you've seen the first film, then you'll know the fate of the main protagonist in that, so we did know that he would not be returning. With his group, they scour the landscape and come across zombies trapped in a stairway that looks very similar to the type of iconography that we got in the first film. The undead are clearly not dying, even after being starved for 4 years, and therefore they will likely still be up and nimble, ready to run after their prey at the first opportunity. As mentioned in the plot synopsis, they come across survivors, so it's likely that they were told that there were none. I do believe that the main character will also have to choose between escorting them out or leaving them behind, and this mission will become more about saving their lives rather than getting the MacGuffin. There's a tagline that states, "Escape the apocalypse," so it is possible that there is light at the end of the tunnel. Clearly, with the collapse of the government and other aspects of society, everything is in complete ruin, and we see what looks like it's a prison now being run by the prisoners. They have people fight for survival against the undead in a sort of gladiator arena, and this reminded me a lot of Escape from New York, in which there was a similar sort of scene. Now, by the looks of it, and things that I can make out from the trailer, the crew come across the survivors, and as they are making their way out, they are captured by the prisoners and forced to fight for their entertainment. They then manage to break free and make their way out, but the prisoners do not wish to let them go and chase them to the border of the country, which we see littered throughout the climax. This is all purely guesswork at the moment, but I do think that it's supported by the way things play out in the first look. Now, before we get into our thoughts on the trailer itself, I just want to let you know we're giving away a free copy of the Star Wars Skywalker Saga box set to one random subscriber. All you have to do to be in with a chance of winning is like the video, subscribe to the channel, and leave your thoughts on the trailer in the comments section below. The winner is going to be chosen at random on the 15th of April, and the set will be shipped out from then to whoever gets the prize, so best of luck to everyone who takes part. Okay, so what did we think of the trailer overall? Well, I have to say, it's really not what I was expecting, and though I found it a bit jarring at first, I did enjoy the new direction. My only worry at the moment is that they're taking it to a place that we've seen a number of times before, whereas in contrast to this, the original felt, well, so original. There are flashes of Mad Max, and as I mentioned earlier, Escape from New York, especially with the fight and chase. However, I do have faith in the team behind this that they will inject something different into what's going on, and it will massively defy my expectations. The most interesting part of these films is of course the zombies, and seeing them rush forward with their twisted and flailing bodies will never not be unnerving. So I do have a lot of faith that this will truly deliver something special, and that it will develop upon the aspects of the first film in several engaging and interesting ways. Train to Busan is one of those films that I just often revisit because of how tense the entire thing is, and I'm hoping that this movie does well and secures a franchise for the entire series, as it definitely deserves it. Overall, I am hyped for the first look, and with the movie just over 4 months away, I'm getting more and more excited for it. Hopefully, we'll get another trailer before the film's eventual release, as I imagine there's a lot in it to unpack. I will, of course, keep you up to date with everything in regards to the movie, so make sure you stay locked to the channel for all the updates as they drop. Now, obviously, I'd love to hear your thoughts on the film and the first look, so comment below and let me know. If you enjoyed this video, then please give it a thumbs up. And if you want some more Asian zombie horror stuff to watch, then make sure you check out our theories on Season 3 of Kingdom. We go over who the mysterious new character is, who caused the outbreak, and what's up with the king. If you want to support the channel from as little as 99 cents a month, then please click the join button below. We massively appreciate it, and as a thank you, you get access to content early. If you want to come chat to us after the show, either follow us at DeffinitionYT or click the Discord link in the description below. Those are the best ways to keep up to date with heavy spoilers, so hopefully we'll see you over there very soon. This is a channel for people who are mad into movies, so if that's the kind of thing you like, hit subscribe. Huge thank you for taking the time to watch this. I've been Deffinition, you've been the best, and I'll see you next time. Take care, peace.